Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. Today I am going to start series on attendance management system. In this project, we are going to see three modules, that is admin, teachers and the student. In admin modules, admin can add the courses, subjects, teachers, we can assign the subject to the teachers and add the students, okay? Then in teacher modules, teacher can take the attendance of a student. He can see there how many lectures they have taken for the particular class. And in student module, student can check their attendance, whether they are in defaulter for this month or not. Okay. So in today's video, we are going to see first of all login page. In this login, admin as well as teacher can log in to the project. Okay, for the student login, we are going to see afterward. Okay, so let's create a new project. Attendance system. Okay. Select empty web forms. Okay. Now go to the solution and add one web form. Name it as login. So let's see what I have taken here. Let me add the image here. Here I add one folder. Name it as images. And I am adding the image here. You can see the image has appeared here because I have already linked it in here. Okay. So let's see what's in the design. First of all, in div tag, I have given the style that height is equal to 450 pixel. And inside that div, I have taken one table tag. And the style width 565 pixel, height 421 pixel, background color will be this, and the margin will be the 0 auto. In that table, we have taken table row, we have taken 6 table rows. Okay. Let's see one by one. In first table row, I have taken table data with the call span tool and align it center. Okay. And given one space. After that, I have taken the img image tag here. In that, I have given the source, the image link, and the height here 190 pixel and the width 199 pixel. In second table row, take another table data with the call span is equal to 2 and align is equal to center. Here I have taken h2 header tag 2. In that, I have given the teacher and admin login. Okay, in the third table data, I have taken 2 table data. In that, the first one I have given align is equal to center, width will be the 50%. And here I have taken the bold tag. In that, I have given email ID or user ID. And the second table data, I have taken one text box and one require field validator for validating this text box. Okay, in here I have given the back color transparent, height will be the 29 pixel, width 166 pixel, font bold true, placeholder will be the email, enter email ID or user ID. Okay, here in this required field validator, I have given the control to validate that is textbox 1. We are going to validate the textbox 1 and it will going to display the error message, enter email ID, and the color will be red. Okay, let's see the fourth one. Fourth table row, in that I have taken again two table data. In that first one, align is center and the width will be the 50%. In that I have taken one bold tag, in that I have given the password. And in the second table data, I have taken one text box and one require field validator. Okay, here in text box I have given the transparent color, height the same. Here text mode will be the password and placeholder will be the enter password. Rest will be the same as the above one. Same for the required field validator also. Okay, let's see the fifth one, fifth table row. I have taken one table data, inside that I have given the corresponding value to an alliance center. In that table data, I have taken one button with the text as login, font bold true, height will be the 46 pixel, width 210. Okay, and in the last one, sixth table row, I have taken two table data. Here it's no use, so remove it. I have taken one table data here. In that, I have given the one label with the four color as red, font bold, true for displaying the error message. Now, let's run and see. In Visual Studio 2013, when we use validation, we have to add some code for that. Let's search in Google. And we have to add this app setting code. Copy it. And add in web config. Paste. Save it. Let's run it again. Oh, we have to set this page and then we have to run it. Okay, but we can switch to a login page. Now you can see the login page. Now let's add functionality to read. First of all, let's give some color for this login button. Go to properties. Here in back color, I am giving this color. Okay, now double click on this login button. Now we have to import the classes for this, okay? Using, okay. You can see here this class has been imported. Do same for this using system.data, okay. Now we have to add this connection strings in our webconfig file. Why we are adding our connection in webconfig file? Because here is a place where we can write one time and use it in multiple pages. Okay, it's no. So we don't need to write the connection string in every page for communicating to the database. First property will be the name. I am giving the connection as my connection string name, and then I am giving the connection string here is equals to data source. Data source dot. Then initial catalog, now provider name is equals to system.data. Dot SQL client. Here in connection strings tag, I have taken one add tag. In that I have given the properties. First one is name. Here name indicates the connection name, that is connection. and in connection string I have given the data source is equals to dot. Here data source is my SQL server name, okay, that is dot in my case. And initial catalog is attendance, that is database name is my attendance, that is my database name is attendance. And integrated security is true because we are using Windows authentication, not the SQL authentication. So that's why we have to add here integrity security is equal to true. And then provider name is equal to system.data.sql client. Okay. Now we have to add the connection string here. Now we have to import the namespace for this class. Okay. Now from the configuration manager class, we are going to get the our connection string of name connection, and we have stored it in, and we have stored it in str variable, that is string variable. Now we have provided that connection string in SQL connection class. And now we have taken SQL data adapter for writing the command. What is that? For writing, and we have taken SQL data adapter class. In that we have given the SQL command, that is select star from teacher where t user ID and t password. Okay. Here teacher is my table name, I have two SQL server, that is for 1 2008. The server name is my dot, and the I'm using authentication as Windows authentication, so that's why here integrated security true we have to given, or else if we are using SQL authentication this one, then we have to provide the user ID and password also, and your server name is dot. That's why I have taken the data source is equals to dot. Okay. Now sometimes didn't connect to the database, for that we have to restart our services, SQL services. Now connect and see. So it's connected to our database. Expanded database, and here attendance is my database for this project. In that I have having table teacher. Let's see what is the design for the teacher. In teacher table I am having four columns, that is TID, that is teacher ID, teacher name, teacher user ID and the teacher password. Okay. Now let's see here what I have taken here. Select star from teacher where T user ID is equal to this and the t password is equal to this. Based on this, it will going to based on the user teacher user ID and the password, it will going to get the record, fetch the record, and going to store in data table. And for storing that values in data table, we have to use fill method of SQL data adapter method. For that, we have to use fill method of SQL data adapter classes. After that, this is for teacher login. If admin is log, if admin tries to login, then it will going to check that the value from of in the text box one is equal to admin and the second text box value is equal to 123. Then it will going to redirect the admin to the admin home page. That means admin will going to login, okay, or else it will going to check that the record stored in this data table is count is equal to 1, then it will going to get the teacher ID within that, because here I have given the select star form. Star means the all records for the particular teacher user ID. Okay, it will going to get all the records for the following teacher. Okay, and in that we have having teacher ID, teacher name, teacher user ID, and teacher password. All these four fields going to be come in this data table. That's why we are going to first of all teacher ID, and then teacher name, and then teacher user ID, and going to store it in session. Okay. After that, it storing it in session, then it will redirect the teacher to the teacher home page. Or else, if login fail, then it will go into the display the login failed error message with the red color. Okay, let's run and see. Let me add your debug point. First of all, we are going to check the admin login. Now our debug point has came here. Press F10 to move forward. What it says here, additional keyword not supported, integrated security. Okay, we have having spelling mistake here in web config connection string. Spelling is correct. Let's save and run it again. Press F10. Again, shows your towards your integrated yeah, instead of integrity we have to add integrated, sorry for that. So again showing error here. Let's see. What's the problem with it? Nice purple. If you want to check the query inside that, click here. Yeah. And which query we have given? Select. So go here. You can see the command text is equal to select star for teacher where t user id is equal to admin and the t password is equal to 123. Let's see what's in the value here. Nothing. It's having no value inside that because it didn't get the value from the teacher table. That's why no record had been stored in the data table. Now it is going to check for the here admin. The text box one text is admin. That is equals to admin. It is true. And the text box 2 is equals to 123. Now it's mean the user the admin has logged in and it will going to redirect to this admin home page, but we have not created this page, so it will going to show error. So let's create page for this. Add platform. And one page for this teacher home. बाय। क्लिक ऑन कंटिन्यू और इट सेज योर सॉरी लेट्स रन इन अगेन। Click on continue. Now it's returned to the admin home page. Go back and let's try login for the teacher. Press F10 to continue. Here in select command you can see the command text is visible. Select star from teacher where teacher's ID is visible, this and the password is 123. Okay, now this record is present in our table, so it will going to display the records and going to get going to store in this data table. After this statement is now save. Now after this it will fill, it has filled the, after this statement it has filled the records in data table. So let's see in data table the record has filled or not. Here you can see the record has been filled here. Now from here, first of all I am going to get the teacher ID here, and it's going to store in the session teacher ID and teacher name. Okay, like this way, then teacher user ID, all these three column value I am going to store in the session for the login and logout purpose. Press F10. It checks here that the text box one value is equal to admin. No, then it will directly jump to the else part here, else if part. And here it will going to check that the data table rows.count is equal to 1. Yeah, it's the count in data table rows is equal to 1. It's true. That's why it will do go inside this statement. In this condition here, it will going to get the first teacher ID, then teacher name, then teacher user ID. All the three session has been created. Now it will going to redirect the teacher to the teacher home page. So we can see the your teacher home page message. Okay, so this is the first part of our attendance management system project, that is login page. After that we are going to create the master page for the admin module and the master page for the attendance, that is teacher module, and the master page for the student module. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you for watching.